amazing grace. My chains are gone. I've been set free. My God, my Savior
has ransomed me.
Oh, and like a flood, His mercy rains, unending love. Amazing. The Lord has promised good to me. His word, my hope secures. He will my shield and portion be as long as life is good.
My chains are gone.
Amazing grace. My chains are gone. I've been set free. My God, my Savior
has ransomed me.
Oh, and like a flood,
His mercy rains.
Amazing grace, and the earth shall soon dissolve like snow. The sun forbear to shine, but God, who called me here below, will be for.
Just sing it again. Oh, my chains are gone.
Seen the mountain of their sin just disappear. Oh, for anyone who's ever felt the hand of heaven reach down through their fears and dry their tears. For any life that once was empty now finds itself alive and full of songs, a victory songs. Then you'll understand the reason for the way the saints of God may carry on. Oh, 'cause when I shout, no one's shouting, from a heart that's been washed clean. When I run, no one's running, from a past that's been redeemed. To the world it might look crazy, there's just no telling what you're gonna do. In that moment gets a hold of you. 'Cause when I shout, when I shout, seen. The mountain of their sin just disappeared.
Come on, do you remember that day?
Oh, for anyone who's ever felt the hand of heaven reach down through their fears and dry their tears. For any life that once was empty now finds itself alive and full of songs, the victory song. Then you'll understand the reason for the way the saints of God may carry on.
Hey, 'cause when I shout, no one's shouting from a heart that's been once clean. When I run, no one's running from a past that's been redeemed. To the world it might look crazy, there's just no telling what you're gonna do. In that moment, Jesus gets a hold of me.
Come on, anybody remember that day?
Hey, when I shout, no, I'm shouting from a heart that's been once clean.
Oh,
when I run, no, I'm running from a past that's been redeemed.
Oh,
to the world it might look crazy, there's just no telling what you're gonna do. In that moment, Jesus gets a hold of you.
Oh, and for anyone who knows the hope that keeps them moving on through troubled days, for anyone who knows they have a future and a hope beyond the grave. You see, every life's a different story, how he brought us out of darkness into light.
Hey, there's no way to keep us silent. Every breath's another chance to testify.
Come on, when I shout,
when I shout, no, I'm shouting from a heart that's been washed clean. When I run, no, I'm running from a past that's been world it might look crazy, there's just no telling what you're gonna do.
No telling what you're gonna do.
Only Jesus gets a hold of
you. Come on, why don't you let him get a hold of you today?
When I shout, no, I'm shouting from a heart that's been washed clean.
And
when I run, no, I'm running from a past that's been redeemed.
Oh,
to the world it might look crazy, there's just no telling what you're gonna do. In that moment, Jesus gets a hold of you.
My past erased, my name he changed. Let's testify. My past erased, my name he changed. Let's testify.
Come on, do you have that testimony today?
My past erased,
my name he changed.
My name he changed. Let's testify.
Oh, why don't you lift your hands and testify today?
My past erased, my name he changed. Let's testify.
Hey,
to the world it might look crazy, there's just no telling what you're
said somebody ought to testify in this house right now. Come on, has he been good to you?
Stage four. Her lungs are healed. Her liver is healed.
Yeah.
One of these, she's got left. It's a piece on her side.
Come on.
And the Lord Jesus is going to heal
Come
that
on.
Too.
We believe it.
And my mother-in-law.
Yes. We believe it.
She had her nose removed from the cancer.
Yeah.
Guess what's happening now? She's getting healed.
Come on.
Again.
Come on.
Lord, people need to know that Jesus is out there.
Right.
He is healing.
Yeah.
He is doing what he needs.
Amen.
To. And we are the witness of this.
Amen.
Oh, that
Praise
sounds like a good
God.
Testimony to me today. Woo! I said that sounds like a good testimony today of the goodness of God, of the healing power of God, of the grace and mercy of God. Oh, come on, somebody ought to lift up a shout today. Share your testimony as far as the reports that you received. I think it was last week or maybe the week before. We might as well just have an old-fashioned testimony service here for just the next few moments and hear the goodness of God and what he's done for us. We've been praying for miracles to take place, for signs and wonders to follow them that believe, and we're experiencing them right now. Listen to this.
6 months before God healed Rhonda of leukemia, Brother Filkins, missionary to France, came from the podium as we came into a Wednesday night Bible study a little bit late, and he came to me directly and said, "We need to pray for your wife." He didn't say what was going on. He said, "We need to pray for your wife. She has a need in her body," and we, being apostolic, understand those kind of things, and we just took hands. He prayed, went back and started all over. And he said, when we got home, I said, "Are you not telling me something? Are you sick?" And she was feeling under her rib cage here and said, "I had a sore spot and it's gone." 6 months later, we could put our hand around this growth right here, and we did not relate it until 3 weeks of diagnosis. They finally told her she had hairy cell leukemia, and that was her spleen producing white blood cells, and it had dropped down, and we could put our hand around it. Very dangerous, but nonetheless, we finally understood, and when we got the report, Daron was a baby, and Radonna, and we were sitting on the dining room floor weeping. We had just got the report, and you know what goes through your mind. 5 minutes of fear, and all of a sudden we looked at each other and said, "God has already touched you. He healed you 6 months ago. Why is this manifesting now?" I'm here to tell somebody today, he's already done the job. I want to learn how to believe. I want to know how to get rid of unbelief. I want to ask him, and when you begin to worship, you know how it feels. It's like you can run through a troop and leap over a wall. Hallelujah. James was talking about it last week. Last night I said, you know, when you start talking like that, you think the enemy's just going to lay down? So I say, why not worship? Why not a word of testimony? Why don't somebody stand up and say, he's done it for me. He's already took my pain, my sickness, my disease is gone in the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah. Come on, somebody ought to shout with a voice of triumph right now. Come on, you ought to shout with a voice of triumph right now. Ask what you will and it shall be done. Come on here. In the name of Jesus. Let a healing come right now. In Jesus' name. Come on. There's miracles taking place right now. My brother was scheduled to preach today. I wanted to come and speak the word of faith over you right now because I believe that God wants to work a miracle in your family. Maybe it's a situation that you don't even have with you today, but you can face it tomorrow. But I believe that God's going to give us a word of faith right now and that you can receive what you need from him in Jesus' name. Why don't you give the Lord a hand clap of praise right now? Come on, give the Lord some praise right now.
Come on, let's tap into something real here right now. While the Spirit's moving, while the waters are troubled, come on, don't stop, don't quit. Something happening right now in the Spirit. While the waters are being troubled, come on, would you just step in? Would you step in to where the waters are being troubled? I'm going to put your mind at ease here for a moment. I'm not going to preach to you. But I am going to give you the word that God gave me. Because these guys have been running all over it anyway. Jesus, don't quit. Jesus, in John chapter 4, encounters a woman at Jacob's well in a place called Samaria. He told her all of her life story. She runs back to the city. And she tells everybody, come see a man who has told me everything I've ever done. Come see the man who's told me everything. And the conclusion of that story is, in John chapter 4 and verse number 41, said many more believed because of his word. Jesus spends two more days in Samaria and he makes his way back to Galilee And after 2 days of seeing people who believed him just at his word, he encountered who the Bible calls a certain nobleman. And the nobleman said, "Hey, Jesus, I heard you're over here in Cana. I need you to come down to my house. My son is at the point of death." And Jesus turned to that nobleman. And at first glance, you would think that Jesus was being harsh, because he said, "Wait a minute. You're seeking a sign and you're seeking a miracle before you believe me." And look what Jesus did. He did not make a demonstration. See, you have to understand, Jesus was used to the Galileans looking for the sign, looking for the miracle, and then expecting, and then believing. And he meets the nobleman in the way, and he forces him to believe the word, because he does not go to his house. He does not lay hands on his baby. My God, I feel the Holy Ghost. He does not have any outward demonstration. All he did was say, "Go home, your son liveth." And with that single miracle, with that single miracle, Jesus forced the Galileans out of looking for the sign and into believing because of his word. I want to encourage you to tell you today, if his word says, "I can do all things through Christ," I can. If his word said, "No weapon formed against me shall prosper," it won't. If his word said, "You overcome by the blood of the Lamb and the word of your testimony," you will. If his word said, "He'll never forsake you," he won't. If his word said, "By your stripes, you're already healed," you are. Somebody shout, "Yeah!" This message might only be for the Sear family today. James came to me in church. And to some of you, you might have thought he was reading me the riot act. Hand going. It wasn't that at all. But he asked me a question. He said, "I went to the MRI room this week, and I expect to see something." His words were, "I didn't see what I was expecting I would see." He said, "I don't know what you're preaching." I said, "You wait and find out. Brother James, we're not looking for signs because we've got his word. I've already got the word. Don't wait. Shout now. Thank you. what we're going to do. Because some of you are like Simon Peter. You've been toiling all night. Look at this. You've been toiling all night looking for signs of life. You stood at the bow of your boat. Why is everything around me looking dismal? Why does everything around me look dead? Where's the life? Where's the harvest? Where's the miracle? The word of God to you today is this. As Simon Peter said, Jesus, we've toiled all night. We've been looking for the signs of life, but we can't find it anywhere. Nevertheless, at thy word. There it is right there. Come on, don't wait, shout now. Come on, the harvest is on the other side of the nevertheless. When they let down the net the second time, Luke chapter 5 and verse number 6 said, they enclosed a great multitude of fishes, so much so that their net break. I hear the voice of God telling somebody today, as you have come to him saying, Matt, I've been looking for signs of life all night, and I found nothing. But when I shifted my perspective from the sign, when I shifted my view from the sign to the word, look what the Lord has done. When I shifted my perspective from the sign to the word, the miracle was on the other side of the shift. What are you trying to do? I'm trying to get somebody to shift your perspective. Quit looking for the sign and go back to the word. Quit looking for the sign and go. It's already done. It's already done. Eye has not seen, ear has not heard, neither is it entered into the heart of man the things that God has prepared for them that love him. It's already done. It's already done. It's already done. Take him at his word. Come on. Shout, shout, shout. Because the word said it, I have healing now. Not because I see it, but because the word said it. I have a harvest now. Not because I see it, but because the word said it. Shout now. Shout now. Shout now.